Higher elevated blood sugar levels, bad for you. Why do we even care about elevated blood sugar levels? Well, I like to use a simple analogy to help understand why elevated blood sugar levels are bad for you. I want you to imagine putting the perfect amount of sugar in your cup of coffee. When you put the perfect amount of sugar into a cup of coffee, what happens? You put the sugar in, the sugar dissolves, you then drink the coffee, and when you drink the coffee, you can taste the sweetness of the sugar, but there's no actual physical remnant of the sugar. Now, what happens when you put too much sugar into your coffee? When you take the last sip, what happens? You can actually feel the granules of sugar that haven't dissolved. You can feel them on the tip of your tongue. Okay, turns out, if you took a microscope and you examined a granule of table sugar and you compared it to a molecule of blood sugar, geometrically, they're exactly the same shape. They're both shaped like shards of glass. Sharp, jagged, pointy, obtuse edges. All right, now stay with me here. Next thing I want you to do is I want you to take your fingernail and I want you to start to scratch your forearm. Okay, just start scratching. What's starting to happen to your forearm? It's starting to get irritated. What would happen if you kept doing that? If you just kept scratching, eventually you would burst the skin on your forearm. All right, well, if you can understand those little simple things, the reason why elevated blood sugar levels are bad for you is if you have molecules of blood sugar that are shaped like shards of glass circulating through your circulatory system at elevated levels, they start to scrape against the inside of your blood vessels. And if they continue to scrape, eventually they'll damage your blood vessels from the inside out. And that is what the actual complication of diabetes is from. So, let's just think about that for a second and put that into context. What is the most common complication associated with diabetes? Diabetic retinopathy. Why would eye problems be the most common complication? Well, it's simple. Your eyes have the smallest capillaries in the entire body. They're the most susceptible to those shards of sugar damaging them from the inside out. What's the second most common complication associated with diabetes? Foot problems. Why would foot problems be the second most common complication? Your feet have the second thinnest capillaries in the entire body. They're the second most susceptible to shards of sugar damaging them from the inside out. If you see somebody or you know somebody or maybe even you yourself have experienced foot problems associated with your diabetes, maybe even had a toe amputated or even a foot or leg amputated, what's happened is at some point those shards of sugar have damaged the blood vessels from the inside out and have either caused internal bleeding, which that can immediately affect your circulation, or maybe those shards of sugar have damaged the nerve endings, okay? What happens? Well, person living with diabetes, they're walking on the beach, they stub their toe. Because those shards of sugar have damaged the nerve endings connected to their toes, they've lost the sensation of feeling. They don't feel a little cut. That little cut now turns into an infected wound. That infected wound turns into a festering sore. And now all of a sudden, a couple weeks later, you finally notice, oh my God, what's going on? I have this terrible problem happening with my foot. That all dials back to shards of sugar damaging your blood vessels, your capillaries, and your nerve endings from the inside out. So, if you don't remember anything else about diabetes or anything else about what we talk about here, remember this. Diabetes is a disease of elevated blood sugar levels. And the reason why elevated blood sugar levels are bad for you is elevated blood sugar levels damage your blood vessels from the inside out. Okay, so hopefully this information has been valuable to you. If you have any questions, just leave a comment. You can always check us out at glucosezone.com or email us. Send us a message on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. We're happy to answer any questions you might have related to diabetes and exercise.